diya.
Okay. So, you know, as most of you guys would know, Emraan is an author too, and we published his book some time back, which is a huge bestseller and continues to sell. But today we are here for Bihar Diaries, and he's very kindly, you know, agreed to launch the book here.
Off the record, you know, he just said that, why don't you write a book? And I know people in Mumbai, in Penguin. Then Mr. Hussain Zaidi, who is India's best crime novelist, number one crime novelist, he called me from Mumbai. And here it is, Bihar Diaries is in front of you, but all because of Emraan. You know, he helped me tick off one thing off the list of my bucket list.
Well, thank you again, Emraan. You know, we wouldn't be here without you. But how did you meet Amit? And, you know, tell us a bit about interaction and some, like, secrets about him, if you'd like to spill
secrets.
Them.
Secrets? I don't know how many secrets. Like, I think most of the secrets he spilled in the book. So if you want to know secrets about him, you have to read the book. It's a great read. It's very, very fluid and one of the very thrilling, fast-paced rides that if, you know, you can actually complete in one read. But I met Amit 2 years back, 2.5 years back, was it? In Jaisalmer. I was shooting for a film called Badshah. And there was a BSF event. And I met him over there. I met him slightly before that on the shoot. We went for the BSF event. Then he was very gracious enough to kind of show us around in Jaisalmer one of the evenings. Border pe bhi gaye. And jab hum wapas aa rahe the gaadi mein, it was a 2-hour journey. And Amit couldn't run from me. He was sitting next to me in the car. So I was like, I have to take this opportunity to find out more about, you know, we have a perception of how cops are, how the police is. I've known them before also, but it's always nice to hear firsthand, you know, stories about what you know, the job entails. And we have a very unidimensional viewpoint, which is predominantly based on films that we have seen about the police, things that we've read in the newspapers, some misinformation. So we got talking and we found a lot of commonality, you know, as far as reading and you know, films and lots of other things. And then the next day, we kind of extended that meeting, a longer meeting for almost 3 hours in his office. And I was like, you know, just tell me some anecdotes. And he started off. And I was like, I always thought that we over-dramatize things in films when it came to the police. But then I realized that we are not doing any justice to actually what happens.
But Emraan, you've written a book too. So what is more difficult, you know, acting or writing a book? And what was these two experiences like?
I mean, for me, it was reliving the experience and putting down on paper. So that was a tough one. But it definitely comes up with its own challenges. And that's what I loved about his book, was the fact that it's something that even I wanted to, I don't know how much I achieved it, but just bring in the humane side, the story of the family, about myself. There's always a projection that people have in public domain in front of people. But the reality is far from that. Actors, you know, policemen, anyone. I mean, there's always a perception you have, and that's based on the stories you've heard of them.
Public
persona. And your life is very different from that. So it's very important in that writing process to put out those vulnerabilities, to put out those moments that make you relatable. And I think he's done it beautifully. I've read a long time back, but it was your fear of lizards is there. And then there was a scene in the beginning, a situation where you hit one guy and you said your hand hurt. So, I mean, those are the details that if put in the book, you understand, you feel for the character. It's not just, you know, the superhero film where a policeman comes and fights and saves the day. It's actually going into, it's a very tough job. I mean, when you wear that uniform every morning, it comes with a certain responsibility to, of course, protect the citizens. At the same time, there is a fear for your life. I mean, when you go out for work, your family fears that, you fear that. And if you put that in, that's what he's beautifully done in the book. So that was also a very, very important journey for me, because there was one version where I made people read it and they said that just we want to kind of feel, taste and hear the sounds in every scene that you're kind of journeying out in this book. So that's what I did, and that's what I also kind of I resonates in his book too.
Well, Emraan, I did want to ask you this. You know, do you think the police or the police force in general is portrayed in, you know, in the best possible way in films? And is there a scope of sort of, you know, also sort of delving into the complexity of their lives and, you know, what actually goes on behind the scenes?
I mean, it depends. There's some films that obviously are very true to the book. They actually do their research and get down to pitching that story in an honest way. It depends on the mind of the writer and the eye of the filmmaker, of how he perceives the police or in what context you're telling the story. I mean, there are great books, great films about cops. There are some that are drastically and dramatically blown out of proportion. That is nothing like how cops are. I've had friends also who have donned the uniform, and I mean their lives are far from what we project on screen. But so here's the thing. I mean, if you're going to tell the story in 2 hours, you have to amp up things, and especially in Hindi films. There is a certain kind of cinema where it's of course amped up, and then Bollywood you take it up like 10 notches higher. Like, you know, just one, you know, fist and you have 10 people flying. I doubt that has ever happened. But, I mean, that's what the audience likes. I mean, we have an escapist, cinema viewing experience here where people like to see their heroes larger than life put on that pedestal. But, there have been some great films from Bollywood also.